2019. He's a quick thinker and a good leader. May I now invite Sir to introduce the guest of honor, Dr. Naresh Goel, Deputy Director General, NACO. Amistad, yeah.
Good morning, Chief Secretary Dr. Radhakrishnan, other dignitaries on the dais, delegates and friends. I'm delighted that Dr. Naresh Goel has graced this conference with his presence. Dr. Naresh Goel is Deputy Director, NACO. After his MD and MBBS from Maulana Azad Medical College, he has had a long and distinguished service in WHO and in the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. He has various posts, Assistant Commissioner, Senior Chief Medical Officer, and is currently the Deputy Director General of NACO. Thank you for coming, sir, and we welcome you to this conference.
Before Dr. Naresh Goel addresses us, we have with us Dr. Pramila Lee, who's the nursing superintendent at Christian Medical College, Vellore. She is the patron of this conference. Ma'am is a change agent in nursing. May I now request ma'am to present Dr. Naresh Goel with a shawl and a memento. Over to Dr. Naresh Goel, Deputy Director General, NACO, to deliver the guest of honor address on quality initiatives by NACO.
Thank you very much for inviting me here in this important conference. Respected Principal Secretary Radhakrishnan ji, all Dr. Vijay Agarwal, all other dignitaries on the dais, I especially thank Lalu Joseph who sent me the invitation. And I am among the very literate healthcare providers of this country. That gives me a lot of pleasure, and I feel proud of it because I always heard a lot about CMC Vellore. Similar way, we internationally hear a lot about John Hopkins Public Health School. So I always wish that a lot of work is being done by in public health by CMC Vellore, and I have never visited, being nearly 40 years in health ministry or in hospitals in healthcare field. So this is a great opportunity that I am here. And in fact, when I was working in WHO or immunization field way back in 2005-06, Jacob John, one of the great names of CMC Vellore, used to be there in many international committees, and developed the program of immunization and other areas, worked a lot. Even now we have people from CMC Vellore in our national committees who continuously guide us regarding various aspects of program implementation. So this is my first visit, and the issue, the subject of quality improvement is very close to my heart. And when I was given this charge in NACO regarding this laboratory quality improvement, I was really very, very happy. And in fact, during the course of next 5 years, since I am in NACO, I learned a lot in the, myself regarding this quality improvement, because what we sometimes see from outside, quality, that is not the real thing. And when we enter into the field of quality improvement, then only we realize that there is a lot to be done. So as far as accreditation goes, when I joined the NACO, there were only 10 labs out of 130 that were accredited. But within now next 5 years, since I worked with passion, we have brought this number to 100 plus now. Out of 130, 100 labs of NACO are accredited, NABL accredited, under ISO 15189. So, and that makes us proud, because there are total 1,000 laboratories all over India which are accredited under NABL. And out of those 1,000, 100 are from NACO alone. So 10%, that's a big number, that being in a public health sector, not a private labs. So that's the kind of work NACO is doing. And NACO has always been known internationally for its, they call it a NACO model. NACO model is basically PLHIV centric, evidence based, outcome oriented, and community with community involvement. We always work with the involvement of the community, and that is why NACO model is internationally acclaimed. We have the number of PLHIV is coming down, the prevalence is coming down, number of new infections are coming down, number of AIDS-related deaths are coming down, and we feel that earlier there was a program of polio eradication, and I'll just show you some slides that how the journey of quality improvement at NACO happened in the field of laboratories. This is the journey of NACO, basically from the earlier stages of just IEC and behavior changes, we increased our facilities, ICTCs, and treatment centers, that AIT centers, et cetera, et cetera. And now we have come up with the HIV/AIDS Act also, which takes care of stigma and discrimination in a legal manner. These are our goals. By 2030, we want to eliminate it. And by 2020, we have some targets of reducing the new infections by 75%, achieving the targets of 90-90-90, which is given in the lower box, 90% of all people living with HIV to know their HIV status. 90% of these should be put on treatment, and those put on treatment, 90% should be having effective treatment, that is viral suppression. Then we want to eliminate HIV-related stigma and eliminate mother-to-child transmission. So mother-to-child transmission route, we'd want to totally eliminate by 2020. And we are working a lot for that. So there are three things: prevention, testing, and treatment. So I'll not talk much on prevention and treatment, but on testing only. So we are doing nearly 4 crore, this is the prevalence coming down, new infections coming down, deaths coming down. The focus is on quality. Yeah. So what we do is annually 4 crore, 40 million HIV tests are conducted, and we have to ensure that there is a responsibility on us that all of these tests are correct. If a person is declared negative, must be negative. If a person is declared positive, should be positive. You can understand the consequences. If a positive person is declared negative, or otherwise, a negative person being declared positive. So that is the job which is in our hand. And we conduct nearly 20 lakh CD4 testing. And viral load testing, we have recently started from last year for all those who are on ART, that is 12.5 lakhs people, we'll be doing once a year. So what were the policy level initiatives that were taken? NACO is the only department or division in Health Ministry which has a dedicated laboratory services division. And standardization of tests and technologies, everything is done by a technical resource group. Guidelines and SOPs are framed. There is HR and financial commitment for quality improvement. Since there is a division at the central level, we have in our states also people exclusively for the lab work. Then institutional staff capacity assessment and improvement, and there is a system of monitoring and mentoring. The activities that our division does is quality assurance, of course, is a main one. Rest is the molecular testing, and sometimes newer technologies are evaluated for bringing into the system. Coming back to the quality, there is a three-tier system. We have one apex lab, and then there are NRLs, and CMC Vellore is also one of our national reference laboratory. And then there are 117 state reference laboratories, and now there are nearly 20,000 places, more than 20,000 places, in fact, where the testing happens. And there is a system of reverse testing. This is the just diagrammatically, NRLs, national reference laboratories, are linked to the state reference laboratories. This is all over India. So the quality assurance, how it is done? HIV, there is a consortium, HIV kit consortiums consisting of 4 labs: NARI, NCDC, NICED, and NIMHANS. And what do they do? Whenever kit comes to the system, when we procure it from the manufacturer, before being sent to the field, it is tested by these labs. External quality assessment, that is from the higher level, some panels come to the lower level, that is NRL prepares the panel, they go to the state reference laboratory, and the state reference laboratory sends the panel to the ICTCs. So that concordance is then seen. We have a system of retesting also. From ICTC, there is a, some of the, you know, every quarter, some of the tests are sent to the upper level for concordance checking. And whenever there is an issue, then we do the root cause analysis and find out the solution. Then trainings, capacity building is a constant thing, mentoring, monitoring. Consortium, I think I need not deliberate. This is basically self-sustaining. We charge some money from the manufacturer and for the pre-dispatch testing. Like this is what this is showing is that batches out of 55, batches from April 18 to November 18, 52 were passed and 3 failed. So the batch which is failed is not supplied to the field. This is what I was talking, proficiency testing, retesting, and proficiency testing for CD4 also. And NARI is NABL accredited for proficiency testing. So even for proficiency testing, our NARI lab is further accredited under that ISO 17043. This is the process of administration. We earlier touched upon it. In panel testing, the two rounds come, six monthly. And what we see is generally there is a concordance in panel testing. There is no discordance coming in the last many years now. At SRL level, what we see is the overall participation and discordance in proficiency panel testing. So participation is very good. And this discordance over a period of time, as you see, has come down very much. This is the ICTC participation. We have nearly 85% participation. The discordance here also has come down from 1% to nearly 0.2%. Retesting, this is quarterly activity which is conducted 4 times a year. I was telling you, 20% of all positive and 5% of all negative samples received by each ICTC in the first week of quarter is sent to the state reference laboratory for retesting. So we have basically, what I'm trying to convey is that we have a system of consortium where kits are first tested, then sent to the field, then there is a system of panel testing from the higher level labs, the sample come, predetermined sample of HIV negative or positive, they come to the lower level labs and the concordance is seen, and from ICTC, the sample are retested again to see whether there is a concordance or not. So again, there is a participation is nearly 85%, and from one, we have come to 0.1% in discordance over a period of time. Accreditation, that is what we aim for. Out of 130 NRL and SRLs, we have now 102, 93 are accredited, and 9 have applied. So 102 labs are there in the accredited over a period of time, which is, I mean, very good by any standards, in a, particularly working in a government setup. So beyond HIV, what has happened, taking cue from this HIV accreditation for, including the, in the scope, HIV test, the people have gone beyond. They have gone for CD4 testing accreditation. They have gone for molecular testing. Some labs have totally, entire tests in the Department of Microbiology accredited in NARI Pune, BJ Medical College Pune, NIMHANS Bangalore, JJ Hospital, Mumbai, AMC Dibrugarh, etc. Mentoring and monitoring, this is very much important, continuously training them, calling them, going there, looking how they are working, hand-holding them, retraining them. So this is all very important to keep the status of accreditation on. And so as we have approximately 4 crore, so what we are doing now is that coming to the ICTC level also, where, real test is done, confirmatory test is done at the ICTC, it's Integrated Counseling and Testing Center. So here also, we are implementing QMS, and this is by checklist. And by checklist, initially some baseline is done. After the baseline, then we go for interventions, and then we do the final assessment. We give them scores and star rating. And once that star rating is, five-star rating is assessed by a third party, and once that third party assessment is okay, then a certification is given. This is a new thing that we have started. In ICTCs, we are not going for accreditation, but for certification, and that's all NACO introduced procedure. This is some of the photographs of certifications. So continuous quality improvement is a teamwork. NACO, SACS, State Reference Laboratory, National Reference Laboratory, and our technical support agencies like CDC and Share India participate in this work. So we have some new initiatives. I think I can leave that. That is, NACO is doing by viral load testing of all, those are on ART, and some CD4 machines have also been bought. A new thing that has happened is the HIV AIDS Act. This was notified in e-gazette in April 2017. In 18 we have this, basically it has come into force, and a lot of it, the implementation is from the state side. So the principal secretary is here. I would like to make a request that we try to make rules regarding the ombudsman, etc., at the earliest, so that this can become a real practical thing in the field. So challenges in quality: not enough motivation and leadership in some laboratories, so you have to again and again engage them. Calibration of equipment sometimes is an issue. Supply chain management and providing external quality assurance samples in difficult terrains like northeast or hilly areas, and staff attrition. But they are there. And to summarize my presentation, we have dedicated HR and financial commitment for quality improvement. That's very, very important. If that is not there, then no quality improvement can happen, whether it's government sector or the private sector. Well-defined mechanism for quality assurance, panel testing, reverse testing, consortium, regular hand-holding of labs for NABL accreditation, supervisory and mentoring visits, regular capacity building of all cadres, and result is that out of 130 labs, 93 are accredited and 9 are in cycle. Thank you.